October 7, Asia's largest sports media property, ONE Championship, returns to Myanmar for another night of world-class mixed martial arts action. A Filipino fighter who will get a shot at a title in the event joins us today. We have Joshua Pacio, who will go against strawweight world champion Yoshitaka Naito of Japan. We also have Edward Falayang, who will compete against Shinya Aoki in November for the ONE Championship lightweight belt. Now, also here is a Philam fighter who has made a mark in the MMA scene. We have the one and only brand in the truth, Vera, and the first ONE Championship heavyweight world champion, as well as the championship, or rather, as well as the ONE Championship vice president and three-time MMA world champion, legend, really, Rich Franklin. Good morning, fellas.
Good morning. Good morning.
Thanks for coming out here this early. Now, MMA has experienced, you know, a growth and boom like no other sport out there. What do you guys put that down to?
I think here in this side of the world, I think it's because martial arts, they just transcend from culture to culture.
Sure.
Every culture has some sort of martial art tied to it. Mm-hmm. And so at a very basic human instinctual level, people understand the sport. It's not a sport where if you were to bring the game of American football here, for example, you would have to explain the rules.
Yeah.
And even though the rule system for us is very complex, once two guys enter the cage and they begin to compete, the basic premise needs no explanation.
It's there. It's all the same wherever you go.
Absolutely.
All right. Now, you know, ONE Championship is the biggest event of its type here in Asia. There are many big promotions out there. What makes ONE Championship different from all the other MMA promotions out there?
I think first and foremost, it's our athletes.
Yeah.
Secondly, I think that the rule system that we have in place and our judging criteria really makes for exciting and explosive fights. We have about, with our fights at our shows, we have about an 80% finishing rate.
The fighters headlining many of the fights. We've got three of you guys over here. Edward Falayang, we've got Brandon Vera, and Joshua Pacio over here. Kamusta guys? Kamusta ang preparations? You've got October 7 coming up. Medyo mabigatin ang kalaban. Kamusta ang paghahanda?
Okay lang naman po. Pinaghandaan talaga ito sa conditioning. Tapos, syempre, medyo nape-pressure kasi 1 week na lang.
Oo, tsaka medyo mabigatin tong si Nobita. I mean, Nobita has a perfect record, I think. Are you confident that you're going to be handing him his first loss?
Yeah.
Yes.
A little bit
of the butterflies in the stomach here, and I can understand why. There's a lot riding on this fight, and it's good to see that our Pinoy fighters really rising to the occasion. Ed, what about you? You've got a fight coming up. I think it's November. Title fight, no less. Kamusta ang pag-aanda mo?
Mabuti naman. Yung makakalabang ko is a legend sa mixed martial arts, so pinapag-aralan kung ano yung mga areas na kung saan makakapasok ako.
Ito na mga fighters natin from Baguio, but mukhang lamang na lamang tayo when it comes to fighters coming out of the Mountain Province area. Ano ba talaga ang
sabi nila yung hangin daw, which is nakakatulong nga naman, pero actually yung attitude talaga din ng mga fighters doon. We spend a lot of time na kung saan.
You know, in terms of your preparations and keeping in shape and that sort of thing.
You know, I'm traveling around to all the different cities. I learned here sa Manila, like wherever you're at that day, doon ka lang talaga. Like you're in that city. So I've been visiting a lot of different gyms. I have training partners coming in from the States. Some of my past opponents that I fought in ONE are actually training with me now.
Right.
So basically we're just traveling and training at all the different facilities right now.
Now you've done the rounds. All the fighters really do the rounds at the various promotions. You've had a chance to fight under different promotions. Enjoying your time with ONE?
I love it here with ONE. I will finish my career here with ONE. I'm blessed and Gabor. Actually, just talk to you like a human being, not like a piece of cattle.
Right. Yeah.
It's super refreshing.
Did you get all of that, Rich? Is Brandon going to get a raise here?
I'll just say, as an organization, we instill or we want from our athletes things like honor and courage and respect, like those kind of
Qualities,
absolutely. Mm-hmm. And so, you know, if we expect that from our fighters, then we also want to treat our fighters that way as well. We'll hold ourselves to the same standard.
Well, I mean, you hold a unique position in that you've been an athlete yourself. You've mixed it up in the ring, and now you're one of the executives. And obviously, you bring the concerns of the fighters into management at this point. That's a very unique position.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, there are things that we do. I mean, just smaller things that understanding what the fighters go through in a week and stuff like that. But even to the larger scale things like organization, band, weight cutting through hydration and stuff like that.
It can be a very dangerous thing. I mean, we know that, yeah.
But I'll tell you what's great is walking around during fight week and talking to the fighters. Now, Brandon doesn't have this problem because he's a heavyweight, but all the other fighters who are normally cutting weight and not eating and dehydrating and all that, and you see them walking around happy the day before weigh-ins and eating their food like normal, because in theory they're walking around at, you know, their normal walking weight. That's where they weigh in.
Where they should be.
Absolutely.
Okay. Do you like wearing one hat better than the other? Do you like being a fighter better than being part of the management or vice versa?
They're different. I'll say this. My career, which originated in the States, and I fought in maybe seven different countries or something, and it was nice being able, as an athlete, to help MMA grow. Uh-huh. But now here I am working as an executive outside of the cage, and I'm essentially part of the entire process over again. Yeah. And it's really, really cool to see that happening, you know, a second time. I'm blessed to be in the position I'm in.
Good stuff. Well, we're blessed to have you guys here. We're blessed to have the upcoming fights. Good luck to all of our fighters who are gearing up for the fights. Let's invite everybody. We've got the October 7th fight, and is it the 11th? November?
That's the thing. This is very significant for the Philippines. You know, October 7th, you got Joshua Pacio, who's fighting for the strawweight title.
Yep.
And November 11th, you have Edward Flying fighting for the lightweight title. And then in the first week in December, Brandon will be defending his heavyweight title.
Look at that.
You have the possibility of having three world titles here in the Philippines.
From the Philippines.
Before the end of this year.
This is going to be awesome. We're keeping our fingers crossed, and I know you guys can do it. Marami salama to Edward Flying, Joshua Pacio, Brandon Vera, and of course, Rich Franklin for joining us this morning. Thank you so much, gentlemen, for being here. Marami salama.
Thanks for having us. Thank you.